Hi, a very good afternoon to everyone. And for colleagues, friends that are here today, thank you very much. Okay, let me today run through with you the journey that Jurong Port has undertaken for its digitalization journey. And I'll be showing you some examples as we go along in terms of our implementation for the technologies. All right, what we have here is actually the home port, Jurong Port's home port. And beyond that, right, we actually operate two lighter terminals, one at Penjuru, the other one is at Marina South. Last but not least, we are the operator also at the offshore marine center that's nearer to the Tuas area, right? Okay, Jurong Port has been a gateway port for general and bulk cargo since the 1965, well, the same year that Singapore go independence. Our multi-purpose port expertise lies in the ability to handle all types of cargoes, ranging from general, bulk, container, and also project cargo. As mentioned earlier, we also have the expertise to run an offshore marine facility as well as lighter services. We have invested as well into overseas entities, right? We have joint ventures in Ruichao Port, which is in Shantung, in Yangpu Port in Hainan, and Marunda Terminal near to Jakarta. So all in all, we have three overseas entities that we have actually vested interest in. Whenever possible, we will also invest in automation in order to increase the productivity and efficiencies of the port operations. Okay. Now, to share with you the mission and vision of Jurong Port, the mission is to be an efficient gateway port and to reinforce Singapore Maritime Hub status. And we aim to be a next generation multi-purpose port. Okay, recently, besides the three strategic trusts, okay, naming organization excellence, strengthen the core competencies, business growth, we have actually embraced the leverage on technology to achieve the mission and vision of being a multi-purpose port. Okay, in 2018, right, JP handled around 40 million tons of general and bulk cargo and about 390 TEUs, with the steel and cement being the majority of the cargo being handled today. If we combine all these overseas ventures, we will have handled 36 million tons of general and bulk cargo and 560,000 TEUs of containers. In terms of organization excellence, we were awarded the Green Port Award by APSN and also the winner of National Infocom Award for innovations. Last year, in 2018, we were also the winner of Lloyd's Terminal Operator of the Year. While cargo handling at the wharf still remains our core competencies, we have also moved into developing new capabilities in the creation of port-centric ecosystem, such as the liquid bulk terminal, ready-mixed concrete, LNG, and expanding the footprint of our project logistics. We have developed multi-digital collaboration platforms to improve efficiencies to the industries. With these DCP, digital collaborative platforms, we aim to create more values to JP customer through the use of technology and new and innovative digital solutions. In planning for the future, there are many uncertainties ahead of us. Yet there are certainties that we should and can focus on. Real-time information, for example, automation, mechanizations, big data, AI, machine learning, IoTs, Internet of Things, cybersecurity, connectivities are just some of the technologies that we have heard of many, many times over the course of this year. These are technologies that are certainly coming our way and will be changing the way that we do operate and run our business. And we should be the one that embrace these new technologies and to leverage on it to enhance our capabilities. For instance, real-time online information allow us to have full situation awareness, and this enable us to have ability to take immediate actions and decisions. Dynamic planning enable operational efficiencies and effectiveness, and so on and so forth. So what is our NGMPP vision? In order to reach our goal of being a next-generation multipurpose port, JP needs to focus on two major initiatives. One is the operation transformation of the port, of the waterfront, and the other being the business growth plan. Now, underlying these two plans are the strategic technology roadmap. We have identified the attributes of a NGMPP as being a smart and efficient port, a digital and business-friendly port, and last but not least, a safe, secure, and sustainable port. This is to give you an overview of where all this all the technology fits into the three attributes. Technology has been a great part to play in order to achieve all this, as you have seen in this diagram. Let me share with you a glimpse of the projects that we have been working on in the last few months. Okay. There are more slides, there are more photos today, so I'll probably just explain and walk you guys through. First is the JP Online modernization. JP Online is our main portal and our main application that's servicing the port users. Okay, the purpose of JP Online project is to ensure that we are future ready. At the system architecture level, we have actually engineered everything from ground up. Okay, JP Online is actually a decade old application. So what we have gone through is actually to go back to ground zero to design everything from ground up. Okay, so at this system architecture level, we have built microservices and APIs to ensure that we can easily plug into other ecosystem such as the MSW, the Maritime single window, as well as the network trade platform. These APIs allow us to easily integrate with other business partners for information exchange and for data connectivity. The architecture also supports agile development so that we can develop and deploy applications quickly. Okay, to give you a quick glimpse of how the new JP Online looks like, this new portal has a very modern look and feel. We also want to ensure that the portal supports mobile devices, which is getting more and more common nowadays. So the old application runs only on web, on desktop, on web. This new application is responsive, so it will be able to support any four factors that the users decides to use. Okay, this is a handful. So this is the technology stack that JP has actually embraced on, right? We have actually adopted. So 80% of the architecture is new to Jurong Port, and these are what we have actually gone through in the last 1 year. Okay, again, designing and developing everything from ground up. Okay, so this architecture is based on open standards and platforms. It is to ensure interoperability between new and existing legacy systems within JP and with those external partners. Most of these are very, very new to JP. We have worked with one of our technology partner to design it from ground up. The next technology we have actually embraced on is actually Mesosphere, something that could be new for quite a number of you. It is to manage all the service resources in a secure manner. The use of containers and dockers allows spinning up of servers very quickly and dynamically. Today, we could be running 4 servers. Within 10 minutes, we can spin up 40 servers as the business growth. So in the context of the new world, right, the ability to scale up and scale out is essential. So this new architecture allows us to do so. I will not go into much of all these components in detail, but for anyone who is technical and wants to talk about it on one-to-one, please approach me after this session. Okay, for the ease of new software deployment, and again for the speed of enhancement and deployment, we adopted the blue and green lane deployment approach, which allows for minimum downtime and instant rollback in case of any issues. So from a version upgrade, the deployment will be within a few minutes, and if there's issue, we can easily roll back. This new architecture allows for almost zero downtime when upgrading to new versions or rolling back to an earlier version, therefore minimizing any risk. In this new world, there's also a high requirements for logging to ensure that data are actually being monitored. You know, there's cybersecurity is actually a main concern. So therefore, logging becomes very, very essential for monitoring and auditing purposes. So what this new architecture allows for is actually centralization of log files going into what we call ELK, Elasticsearch, Log Slash, as well as Kibana. So Kimbana is actually the platform that will allow us to view the logs in a very, very visualized format so that analytics can be built in order to analyze the activities that is ongoing at the database level and also at the architecture level. Okay, next, let me share with you the other projects that we are on as at today, okay, which is on asset tracking. Asset tracking, we have two parts of it. One of them is actually for equipment tracking. The other part is actually for human tracking. Okay. As at today, we have what we see over here is the installation of three LoRa workstation, LoRa gateways. We have all together from just last week, we have installed another three. So in all, we have six LoRa gateways that's running. We have LoRa's transmitter that already installed on the forklifts within Jurong Port. We are undergoing a pilot, a POC with a company from Pier 71, Tech Vance, if you know them. They are actually going around partnering us to install LoRa's transmitter within our forklift itself. So with this, right, we are able to track very precisely the location of these forklifts, their utilization, their speed, their location, and so on and so forth. So with this, all this data will be captured into our data lake, which I will be covering in a while. As we move into the tracking of human beings, right, we are currently partnering with Samsung, okay, using the Samsung Watch, and also in partnership with M1 and Vault Intel. Vault Intel is actually a New Zealand company which is very much into the tracking of equipment as well as people. So for the tracking of stevedore workers, right, we are planning to use these smartwatches in order for them to be continuously tracked and for their vitals to be continuously monitored. Okay, so the So with this, right, with the Samsung Watch itself, what we will be able to do is we will be able to identify if there's a fault, identification, the heart rate monitoring, and with that, we will be able once the stevedore workers start their job, they will start and stop the session. We will be having geofencing as well as location detection. There will be mass communication out as well. No, the watch itself does as a speaker, so we can communicate broadly and widely to all the workers at the port. There will be periodic check-in to ensure that the workers are actually still at their location, performing the job and have not run into any issues. And last but not least, if there is a fall detected, then emergency alerts can be sent out to their co-workers around the area, as well as to deploy assistance to help the workers that are in trouble. Okay, these are some of the photographs that we have actually gotten in some of the pilots. So we have gotten our Cisco guards to actually wear the watches and do their prowling around. So for every stations that have gone through, right, they will do a check-in, right? And this is generally the output of the tracking itself. So if you look at it, we are able to track one, the battery lives, two, the location of the staff, three, the vitals, the heart rate of the individuals itself. So this gives us a 100% monitoring of staff that is actually working on the ground itself. Okay, last but not least, right, let me share with you what we have done for the Enterprise Data Hub. Okay, this is an architecture that we have actually embraced on. Okay, so information such as vessel operations, cargo, as well as storage operations, truck operations, all this data actually stream into our Enterprise Data Hub, which is hosted in AWS. All this information will be pumped into an AI platform or ML platform in order to learn and to make decisions on behalf of the human beings. If the system finds any discrepancies or any emergencies, an alert will be raised to our integrated command center in order to take actions on. What we have done also at the same time, right, is to actually pump data on a real-time basis from our JP Online, from our financial system, into the Enterprise Data Hub. So with that, right, in future, we will be able to share the data with our counterparts, our partners, or even with the regulators on a real-time basis. So therefore, keeping everybody and all business partners aware of the real-time statistics that JP is able to generate at the ground level. Okay, so with this, right, I briefly have gone through the projects, but in addition to some of the projects I've shown, we are also in active communication with C4NGP on some of our port planning simulation projects, as well as with Data Science Consortium in terms of leveraging on the expertise of their data scientists in terms of carrying out data mining and learning for new, data mining, as well as learning for information from the data we are actually collecting. So with this, I've come to the last slide, and I thank you very much for your attention. Thank you.